What's up, divas? And what's up, divo? So, of course, you know who it is, your girl April. And today is Wednesday, Real Talk Wednesday. So, of course, I am really excited about this video because I have been keeping a secret from you guys for a minute now. And yes, it was a secret. So, sometimes you have to keep secrets because you just never know how they're going to turn out. And I did have this one secret before, and it wasn't like really a secret, but I told you guys, and it really didn't pan out the way I wanted it to. So I kind of like dropped off. I just didn't want to be bothered with the situation. So yeah, but anyway, so like I was saying, it is Real Talk Wednesday, and it is freaking hot as hell out in this bitch. Like, okay, it's 81 degrees today. So normally when it's 81 degrees, it's nice out. You get a nice little breeze. It's nice. It is tolerable. Okay? Tolerable. And it's fucking hot outside today because it's humid. Because it wants to rain. So it's humid. I know y'all bitches is probably like 81 degrees. You're talking about it's nice. You get a little breeze. In Arizona, 81 degrees ain't shit. Okay? It's good weather. It's like some people be putting on sweaters when it's like 70 degrees out here. And I just be looking at them like, you psychopath. But 81 for me, it's tolerable because I can't do it when, I mean, I'm used to it now. But when it's like 113, 117 degrees outside, which it has been, you know, it's like, goddamn, it's too fucking hot. I just want to go home. I don't want to be bothered. Don't say nothing to me. Don't look at me. Don't even think about me. That's how mad you be. But when it's 80 degrees, I'll be like, yes. But it's humid. So it's like, okay, it's like New York weather right now. It's humid outside. So it's hot out in this bitch. And this hair is not helping. So, yes, the hair is my Best Lace Wigs wig that I made. They're kinky straight. It's hot as heck. You know what? As it gets older, it gets more kinkier and like more wilder, regardless of how much you wash it. I've been wearing this wig for a while. Like, oh God, it's probably been like six, seven months now, and I still love it. And like, you know what I mean? Like, I've had other wigs, and I just don't keep them because I have this one. They just start looking the same to me after a while. But I'm gonna tell y'all what, it's hot. It's very hot outside. And to have any type of hair on your neck, it's like ridiculous. So you're more or less like trapped. You really don't want to be bothered. But I'm going to tell y'all what, I'm not going to be on here too long today because I have to cook dinner. It is 6:47 at night. Now, normally I would do this early during the daytime, but I had such a busy day. School is about to start this week. Mumsy goes to school Thursday, which is tomorrow. And Nay goes to school next Monday because she starts high school. So I had to go with her to high school today. And then I had to, you know, I've had Tinky all day because my daughter's been at work all day long. So, and then I was tired. I only got like 3 hours of sleep. I didn't go to sleep till 4 o'clock in the morning because I was busy making wigs, washing them, styling them, editing videos. If you guys have not checked out my new video, which was me wearing that red hair from Zuri, make sure you check that out. That hair is bomb ass, like on some realness. I love it. I really, really do like it. But if you have not seen my collaboration video with GS Loves Me that I was so happy to announce last week, make sure you check that out. So the videos today are going to be short. I'm going to try to keep it short because I got to cook dinner for my kids. Yes, and I took a nap, and I should have did this early, but I was so tired. I was just tired. So, okay, so let's get into this secret. So a few months back, I was emailed from a company called Guru Glam Makeup, who just has been following me for years and years and years on YouTube. So if you are new to my channel, or this is the first time you have ever subscribed to this channel, then you are not really, you're new. This is actually my third channel. My very first channel, which was Muffin Is My Lovers, got hacked back in August of 2012. And I was like at 77,000 subscribers then. And I got hacked. So I had to start a second channel, which I did, which was Muffin Is My Lovers 2012. That got hacked and / suspended by YouTube. It was like some crazy bullshit. So I started another channel back in 2014. So this is my third channel. So anyway, they have been following me for a year since like my first channel, the owner and so forth. So anyway, I was approached in emails about, you know, just a makeup line. So anyway, I just launched a lipstick collaboration, lipstick line with Guru Makeup, and I chose and picked all my colors that I wanted, as well as every last lipstick in this collection is all about me, meaning all the names geared to what I stand for and who I am as a person, as well as the colors, so as well as the packaging. So I'm so excited about that I was able to just help design a lipstick line that is just showcases who I am as a person. You know what I mean? There have been other people that have approached me, other cosmetic lines, that basically just wanted me to put my name on something and not really even name. I couldn't even name the lipstick. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't even name the lipstick, which sucks, and I really couldn't pick the color. But this one here, I was able to, and it was just one, I was able to basically give my opinions and of the formulation, the formula, the smell of it, the creation of it, as well as my colors that I wanted, as well as the names and my packaging. So with further ado, I'm really super excited to showcase. I have 6 lipsticks and they are all matte. And these are the packagings for my boxes. This is the Lips Extreme Vibrant Color Rich Pigment Bold Look Matte Lipstick Summer 16 Edition with Muffin Is My Lovers. So I hope you guys can see that on camera. Gosh, focus. I hate when my camera does not focus. Okay, there we go. You guys can probably see it somewhat because I'm probably like so close up. Like, April, back it up some. Okay, so yes, I hope you guys can see it. Either way, I'll put a picture up so you guys can see it. But so yes, this is my lipstick line and it is a limited edition. There are 6 colors in this collection. Like I said, they are all matte. And I'm going to, of course, tell you the names of them. And I'm going to post the website where you guys can get them from. I'm super excited about this because this is something that I wanted to do for the longest. So I was so psyched and what have you when they approached me and asked me to do a lipstick collaboration or a lipstick line with them. So the packaging is really, really nice. Even the names of lipsticks are on the bottom packaging. And the packaging has palm trees. Hello. And where I live at, it's palm trees all over. So, you know what I'm saying? And, of course, it has the beach because it is 2016. Of course, my name is on here. And it just says, it says, with Muffin is My Lovers. I did not want it to say with Miss Muffin is My Lovers because originally, I am Muffin is My Lovers. So, yes, let me show you the names of the lipstick. So, this one is called Smooches. And first of all, if you guys remember me very well, you remember I did have a website called Smooches Accessories. And after every video, before the video ended, that was just my way of saying goodbye to everyone. Just my outro to all my videos, I would just say Smooches, and that would be how I would end my video. So I went ahead and named my website SmoochesAccessories.com. And it was actually a beautiful website. It was well designed by my good friend Donna Perry, who also lives out here in Arizona. That's the reason why I moved out here, because of her. And before I moved to Arizona, I had to take the website down and I just never put it back up. So that was like my baby in my heart, that website, and I was so ecstatic about it, and it meant a lot to me because a lot of the things on there I designed myself. I took all the pictures. I designed a lot of earrings and bracelets on there, so a lot of it meant a lot to me. So I had to, of course, name one of my lipsticks Smooches, which is this beautiful red color, and my hand is already swatched on the back. I wiped it off, but let me tell you, the one that I have on right now is called Gemini because I am a Gemini. But let me tell you guys, I put this on and took a nap and it still was on. The consistency of this matte lipstick, it's not dry. You know how you have some that's chalky and dry and kind of like cakey? It feels like you have on like a lip balm on this lipstick. It's very nourishing. There's vitamin E in it, so it nourishes your lips. But it feels like you have a lip balm on, so it's not all dry, which I love. I'm so happy about that. So this is the red color. Hope you guys can see that. My hand is a mess. And this is Smooches. And yeah, of course I had to name it Smooches because that was my website and it was just red lips. That was my logo, so... Yes. So this one right here is Gemini, which is the color that I have on my lips right now. And you girls know, I love a nude color. I'm very, like, nude. I think, like, the nude colors are the easiest for me to put on my lips. So this is my signature color right here. And, of course, I am a Gemini. So there that goes right there. So, yes, that is Gemini. And I know Jeffree Star, after I chose my name, he has one called Gemini. I'm really hoping that there ain't no beef. You know what I'm saying? Because, listen, that's just the zodiac sign. You don't own the name to it. So, let's just hope that there's no beef, because I really don't want there to be a problem. I really, really don't. So, yes. But that is my signature color, and that is who I am. I am a Gemini. So, a lot of all these lipsticks mean everything to me. There's a meaning behind each one. This one is called No Filter, and it's kind of like another color that I like to wear, which is like a matte kind of like peachy pink color. And look at that color. Do you see that? Like, this is so freaking pretty. So, No Filter. My daughter Tatiana is always saying how I don't have no filter. I'm always going off on somebody. I don't sugarcoat nothing. I don't have no filter. I just say how it is. And it's not like my intentions to be like that, but that's who I am. And she's always like, you have no filter. You never have no filter. Mommy, you have no filter. My kids always say that. You don't got no filter. Some of my friends be like, you don't have no filter. The little bit of friends I do have, they be like, you don't have no filter. So that's no filter, because I ain't got no filter. So, hey, it is what it is. And so I wanted this bright color here because it's blinding, it's bright, but it's matte, and ain't no filter on this, so, okay? Sweetums is another one that means a lot to me, and this is my grandson. My very first grandson, his name is actually Jerron Jr., but we started calling him Sweetums, and that's all we call him is Sweetums. And he's different, and he's kind of, he's just bold. He's bold to me, and he's totally different, and he's just out of the norm to me, but he's out of the norm in a lovable type of way, and I appreciate him and love him so much. So I decided to go with this purple, like this very shocking purple, which is a gorgeous color. I'm gonna have to send this collection out to my girl, Miss Shay Love, because she loved purple. But yes, this is Sweetums right here, this purple color right here. And like I said, this is after my grandson, so I thought it was a cute name, Sweetums. Purple is like a sweet color. A lot of people love purple. Purple candy, purple soda. So, yes, this is Sweetums. And it wasn't too dark because it is summertime. But you can also wear this color in the fall and winter if you like as well. This one here is called, pick the same one up, Tinky. Now, you guys know my next grandson, who is 1.5, who I'm always with. This his name is actually Cameron, but we call him, his original nickname was Nuggets. That's what my daughter started calling him, but I just decided to call him Tinky Man. So, for short, I call him Tinky, and Tinky to me is like bright. He's just like shocking. He could be something else sometimes. And sometimes me and him don't mix too well, but we still love each other. And that's how I feel about with this color pink right here. Like, I love the color pink, but some pinks I just don't do. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes me and Tinky just be having our clashing moments. But you know what? I love pink so much that I will do it. And with me and him, he loved me so much that he just pushed everybody else aside sometimes just to be around me. So I love this color pink, and it's a very bright, kind of like fuchsia pink for those of you who love this color pink. So that is Tinky right here, and I know my daughter Tati is probably going to be like, let me get that, but I'm going to make sure that she gets a set too. And the last one, last but not least, is Moved On. So if y'all guys know me so well, you know why I moved on. I moved from New York to Arizona, from the East Coast to the West Coast. I moved on with my life. I moved on by getting a divorce. I moved on. So, moved on, yes. And moved on is this bright, kind of like, it kind of reminds me of Lady Danger from MAC. It's a very bright, pretty orange. And it's right here next to the red. So, yes, moved on. Okay, and when you move on, to me, the reason why I chose this color for moved on is because when I lived in New York, you really couldn't see, like, the sunset. It was kind of dirty. It just wasn't cheery. And I'll never forget one night that I came outside because I had my balcony blinds pulled back. And it was, like, this fire in the sky. And it wasn't really even a fire, but I didn't know what it was. It was, like, 5 in the morning. And I went outside. I took a picture. And it's still on my Instagram to this day. It was the sun rising. And it was like this orangey red color. And it was like fire. And I was just like so amazed because I had never seen anything like that in my life, especially in person. Like, you can see stuff like that on pictures all day long. But to go outside and see that shit in person, it was just like, wow. So it reminded me a lot of these colors right here, this orange, because the sky was like orange. And I posted the picture on my Instagram with no filter. I didn't use any filter on it. I just posted it as it was. And it was just like, it was like very pretty to me and peaceful, but it was something different for me. And so that's what I noticed when I first moved out here. So yes, so that is my lipstick collection line. And I am so excited about it. I will post the link below. Make sure you guys check it out. They do run $16 each, but trust me, it is so well worth it. Totally, totally well worth it. And they do have another, they do have a palette that's called Facebook that is gorgeous. And they also have some shirts on their website. But they do have a eyeshadow palette that is absolutely gorgeous, which is called Facebook. Oh my God, you guys have to get that palette. And also, my girl Passion Jones will be coming out with a makeup line as well with them. So check out their website. But yes, so I am super excited and I'm very thankful, and I want to thank everybody who has hung in there with me, old or new, for all of this, because if it wasn't for you guys, then I wouldn't even be on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? I would not be on YouTube at all, and none of this would be possible for me. So I'm really, really excited about this. And yes, hunties, we're about to do some makeup looks with this, okay? Yes. But yes, just support your girl, spread the love, share this with everybody, and let them know about my lipstick line. You know what I'm saying? I'm not as big as a lot of the other YouTube gurus that have their own makeup line, but this meant a lot to me, so I'm like super excited about these colors. So let's do this. Let's get into this real talk. Like I was saying, if you need a real talk video about yourself, meaning if you have a situation or a friend or family, you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Make sure you put in the subject line real talk so I know that it is a real talk. And if you want to change the names of who you are in the email, then you can all, by all means, go ahead and do so and let me know in the email. So yes, you guys, let's get into this. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's get this first one. It's long. Hello, she writes. Just wanted to let you know I love you and your channel. I'm sorry if this is too long, but I need some advice on this situation because family and friends are no help. I'm sorry if this email is super long, she goes again. You can call me Bree and the guy Chad. So I met Chad on a dating site and we were talking for a while before we actually met in person and we just clicked. So we have been hanging out for a while. Some background on us. I'm black and come from like an urban background, raised by family members because my mother was a drug addict and my father was deceased. I've had to work hard for the things that I have in my life and try my best to take care of me and my 10-year-old son. Chad is a white guy. He's 23 and I'm 29. So there is a bit of an age difference, but that's not the biggest problem. I don't really care about the age difference. He comes from the country with a strict religious background. He still lives at home with his parents and has like 12 brothers and sisters. I have had more experience with relationships and have been hurt in the past, especially with my ex having a problem with talking to other chicks on the internet through dating sites. He knows this too. Chad knows of this too. Now, I don't know if it's because he hasn't had a lot of attention from girls growing up and he just strives for chicks to like him, but I have run into this problem with Chad. I'm his first serious girlfriend and I took his virginity. Yes, girl, I probably should have not been his first, but it is what it is. So I caught him a couple times talking to chicks on the Kik app, the K-I-K Kik app that he's met off dating sites, and the conversations crossed the line. Pictures are exchanged and dirty talk is talked. makes me sick to my stomach. We care for each other, but I don't think he cares enough for me to be faithful. And I just can't go through this bullshit again. This is an email he sent me today, and I haven't responded yet. So Chad has sent Bree an email. Please do not feel in any way that I... Okay, so basically, dear Bree from Chad, please do not feel in any way that what I did was your fault. Bree, it was entirely on me, and I made the choice to continue talking to her, even though I knew it was wrong. My body was telling me to stop it, and I did not listen. Instead, I gave in to my temptations because I was weak and obviously did not care about you or our relationship enough to stop at that time. I am not going to make up excuses as to why I did what I did because it's plain and simple. I cheated on you. Not in the physical way, but it doesn't make a difference. As you saw what I did, no honest man would do if he was with an amazing girl like you. I was weak and not strong enough to fight temptations and for us. Can I blame what I did to the fact that I did not get much attention from girls most of my life? I could, but that is not going to change things now. All I can do now is hope you will have someday be able to forgive me for what I have done to you and be the man I know I can be. The honest and good guy you know I can be. That's what's so amazing about you is that you see the good in people, even though they have hurt you too many times to count. I want to be more transparent with you and hope someday to gain your trust back. I know it will be a long time before that, but I do not mind because you are more than worth it, Bree. I don't expect things to go back to the way they were before Monday, but I'd like to start completely over and do things right. Now, here's the twist. The person that I caught him with this last time. Now, this is Bree writing back to me. Now, here's the twist, April. The person that I caught him with this last time was actually me pretending to be someone else. Fucked up, I know, but I had to see if he was going to take the bait, and he did. I was thinking about breaking it off because of some of the other things I'm not happy with in our relationship. I didn't expect us to get this far into the relationship because at first we were just hanging out and having fun. He's very shy, and it takes a lot to get him to open up. On top of that, he has ADD, which he's on medication for, and that affects his personality too. Oh, ADD, excuse me. He's very childish, which could be due to his upbringing, and the sex is just not great. I have to tell him what to do all the time, and he just has no confidence in the bedroom. I was willing to work through these issues with him and see if we could make it work until the situation happened with the Kick app again and him chatting with this chick. What is your advice? Wow. Okay, so, first of all, Bree is 29 and her boyfriend is 23. Bree is black and she's got a 10-year-old son. And Chad is white and he ain't got no kids. And he still lives at home with his parents. They had a good relationship until she keep catching him on that fucking Kick app. Talking to all type of little young bitches or bitches in general that he's met online. Exchanging photos, dirty talking. So she set his ass up. And yeah, she set him up and basically pretended to be somebody else, and he took the bait, and now he's emailing her. And damn, I wish I would have got this 6 days ago, but she emailed me the day after I did Real Talk. So here's the thing. He wants her to forgive him, and he's like, I know you can basically forgive me because you always see the good in people, even if they have hurt you several times, etc., etc. Is that your way of trying to open up the doors to get back in my motherfucking pants? Not only that, but his sex is whack. He's childish. He's shy. He's a liar. He's a cheater. And he has no confidence in the bedroom. He has ADD. Basically, he lives at home. Age is not a number. Age is just a number. It's not like a big factor in relationships a lot of the times. But here's the thing. Bree, you're almost 30 and he's still kind of like a teenager to me. He's 23 years old. He's my son's age. My son will be 24 this August, the 23rd of August. He'll be 24 years old. And it's kind of like, I know my son, and I know what type of person he is and what type of person he can be. He has matured a lot, but he's still young. He's still young-minded because he's 23 years old. And you're 29, and you have a 10-year-old child. So you are, in a lot of a sense, a lot more mature than he is. You have grown up a lot. And unfortunately, I'm sitting here dusting shit off. unfortunately, he is not that type of person. Me, personally, I wouldn't even bother giving him another chance. And that's just me. That's my take on it. Only because, for one, he's 23 years old. He still lives at home. He doesn't really understand what a relationship is. You're the one that took his virginity. So maybe that's the reason why he's not that good in bed. Because he doesn't have an experience. But now that you've given him some type of experience, girl, please, he's trying to open up to every bitch on the internet. But here's the thing. Why is he conversing with females on the internet still? If he is with you, he should not be on any type of app conversing with any females, exchanging any pictures, and dirty talking to anybody. So you gave him a bait and he fell for it. That just shows you that, you know what, he is going to continue with his childish behaviors. And even though he's wrote you this email and is telling you, you know, oh, you're a very forgiving person, you know, the person that I could be, you're an amazing person, you know that I could be the man for you. Okay, a lot of them say that all the time. Boy, bye, you 23 years old. What man are you really going to grow up to be that quick? You still live at home with your parents and you don't even know how to fuck. You humping. You humping because you're a little boy. You humping. You know what I'm saying? Like, you humping still. But... honestly, in my opinion, I wouldn't even give him the thought again. Because for one, thank God it was you. It doesn't matter if it was you that gave him the bait. It really doesn't matter if that were you that did that to him and set him up like that. Because either way, neither here nor there, he can't blame you for it and you cannot blame yourself for it. He took the bait, okay? You could have had somebody else set him up. Either way, he took the bait and he fell for it. He fell for it. So it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is to him. It could have been somebody else. What if it wasn't you? You know what I'm saying? What if it wasn't you and he, you know, he took the bait and it wasn't even a bait. It was just a female in general who was trying to get with him. And he went along with it. And then he continuously went along with it. And he continuously decided, you know what? I'm just going to continuously talk to this female because Bree don't know. And what Bree don't know won't hurt her. And if you wouldn't have said anything about it to him, he would have continued on. So he got caught. And now, being that he's gotten caught, his thing is, oh, you know, I shouldn't have did this. I didn't care about a relationship. Basically, he's giving you the sob story. And I'm sorry, I'm sitting here dusting off, but it just drives me crazy to see dust on my picture frame. It's very dusty out here in Arizona. But yeah, now he's giving you the sob story, like, you know, I wasn't thinking about you and our relationship. I wasn't thinking about your son. I wasn't thinking about how amazing person you was. They always give you that fucking sob story when they get caught out there. So don't think that what he's telling you is some new shit, because it's really, really not. He's just trying to get over. And of course, they're going to brown nose and be all lovey-dovey for, you know, however long it takes for you to forgive them. And then they're just going to go back to the same bullshit ways. If you have caught him enough and numerous times, then you know what? He's not going to change overnight, and he's not going to change because you want him to change, and he's not going to change because you set his ass up. He's just going to continue to be Chad, who the fuck he is, a 23-year-old young boy. Regardless of his race, he's a man in a boy's body, okay? Or a boy in a man's body, whatever you want to call it. He's childish, and he's not going to be able to understand a relationship until he's old enough and mature. He still lives at home. What do you expect? You know what I'm saying? He still lives at home. He doesn't even really know what the real world is like. And okay, so what? You took his virginity. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. He's 23 years old. Some people don't lose their virginity until never. Okay? But he is not experienced. And fortunately, of course, he's not going to have a lot of confidence in the bedroom because you are his first. So over time, they do get a little bit of, they learn a little bit more. And if you have to guide him, then that's what you have to do. But I don't really think you even need to guide him. I think what you need to do is just leave him alone, because he's more than a headache than anything. He's 23 years old. He's still more or less like a teenager. He's acting like one. He lives at home. He doesn't have any responsibilities, nor does he have a care in the world, especially for your feelings as well as your son's feelings. You know what I'm saying? And I save your son because you're a package deal. And we go through a lot as women when relationships don't go our way, or not even our way, but they don't go correctly. And a lot of times this hurt can reflect onto our kids, and they can see this within us. And I don't think that it's fair for our children to have to go through things that they just don't have to go through. And I can be the first to say that, because of course I've had a husband and I've stuck it out with him for 70 years, and I loved him very much. And to this day, I still do love him. I can never hate anyone. But I stuck it out for the sense of my children, which I really didn't need to. And then with my last relationship with this asshole, which was my son's father, you know what I'm saying? I tried to make it work for them and for him. And what did he do? He actually wrote dumb shit on Facebook to random bitches about my daughter's weight, about my kids, and just did some really grimy shit. And what's fucked up about it is my kids really did like him a lot. And for the way that it went down and to see how it went down, that kind of like bothered them a lot. So as women, we do take on a lot in our lives, and it has a lot to do with relationships. And me, okay, you did meet Chad online. And just like that white boy, I met him online. I decided to just leave the dating scene alone. Everybody does want a relationship, and like I say that all the time, you guys, it's great to have someone in your life. But now I'm so focused on, and I've always been focused on, getting money and taking care of my kids. So now it's like, you know what, I don't even give a damn about a man. If I find one, I find one. If I come across one, I do. But I'm really not even interested anymore, especially with just the experiences that I've had to go through, dirty microwaves and shit. And like a lot of people said, well, why did you meet him out of public? I did meet white boy, blue eyes, out in public. We went on a lot of dates out in public. So, you know, this was like well into the works. But yeah, that was the second time that I went to his house, and I seen the dirty microwave. So yeah, anyway, but I really think that you need to leave Chad alone, and just kick his ass to the curbs, because he's a loser. And I really think he's a loser. He's gonna continue to talk to who it is, whoever it is, on any kind of kick app. That freaking app is like for kids. Like, I'm sorry, but isn't that like a teenager app? You know what I'm saying? When I had downloaded it, it said basically for teenagers. And I was just like, oh, yeah, this is not for me. I am really not about to, get rid of him. He is just not worth your time on some real shit. Sorry about that, Bray. But, yeah. Okay, so here goes the next one. This is really short. Hey, Ziva, look, real talk. I have been married for 15 years and cheated on my husband 9 years ago. He decided to forgive me. However, I have been so upset about my past and mistakes that I haven't been able to talk to him with respect. I seem to find myself yelling at him for no reason. He finally had enough and decided that he wants a divorce. I can understand that, but am so not ready for that. How do I get used to being a single mom of 3 kids? I have no job. I also have a misdemeanor on my background check, which has hindered me from getting any decent jobs. I am currently an LPN, but to find a job and take care of my 6-year-old daughter, I can't understand why now leaving me while I'm down. April, can you give me some tips on how to cope with my divorce? Okay, so she didn't give me a name, but we're just going to call her Nurse. So Nurse has been married for 15 years. She cheated on her husband 9 years ago, and he's basically forgave her. But because of her lack of respect to him, he has finally decided to chuck it, call it quits, and get a divorce. And all she does is complain and yell at him, basically, and he can't take it anymore. So he is leaving her. She has 3 children. She doesn't have a job. She has a misdemeanor on her background record, and which is hindering her from getting any decent jobs. And she just doesn't know how to cope with divorce. Basically, she's just not ready. So here's the thing, Nurse, okay? You got a misdemeanor. What the fuck is a misdemeanor? That's really nothing. A misdemeanor does not help you, or that does not hinder you from getting any real good jobs. Okay, I've got a freaking record. I'm not going to say my record is a mile long, but my record is long enough. And a lot of it has to do, well, it all has to do with assault charges to people. Because I don't know how to keep my hands to myself sometimes. But, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't hinder you from getting a good job. Now, here's the thing, honey. You better hurry up and find a job, because you have 3 children to take care of. But if those 3 children are your husband's 3 children, which I'm pretty sure they are since you have been married for 15 years, I am pretty sure he is going to make sure that your children are okay. But here's the thing. How do you cope with divorce? I really can't explain that to you because me and your situation is totally different. I was ready for it. You know what I'm saying? I guess it would be different if he was the one that was divorcing me, but I was the divorcer. You know what I mean? I was the one that was divorcing him. So I was ready for it. But however, on his part, he was not. So he didn't really deal with it really well. He started drinking again and just started getting out of control with things again. So, you know, it wasn't something that he wanted. And unfortunately, it ended that way. I don't really, you know, I guess because I was tired. It was really no reason to stay married anymore. If he wasn't who he was and he wasn't a drunk and got in trouble so much with the law, I probably would have stuck it out. But, you know, after a while, a person does get really tired and fed up. And regardless of what you done made them tired and fed up, we do get tired. So I can understand your husband's point of view. Like, you know what, I'm done. You keep fucking yelling at me all the time. But how you cope with it, you have to put in your mindset that, listen, I have children to take care of. I ain't got time to be sitting here crying over no man. And even though he's the one divorcing you, you still have to. And you were the one that was constantly complaining and treating him like shit. And you were the one in the wrong. You still have to stand on your own two feet and be a woman. You've already made this mistake and it was 9 years ago. However, now you got to live it. Do you really love this man? Because if you really love this man, and you know this, then maybe you should fight a little bit harder to get back his love. Because obviously he cared enough and loved you enough to stay in this relationship with you. Because had he not, he would not have still been around and stuck it out with you. And continuously allowed you to kind of like belittle him as a person. And I'm not going to even say belittle him as a man, because we're all human. And I think that we should be treated equal, man or female. But belittle him as a person by just basically yelling and complaining to him all the time. But if you really truly love this man, why don't you fight for his love and affection back? Maybe he's just tired of you and the way you act as a person. He just like, fuck it, I love her to death, but I'm not going to put up with this anymore. Maybe this is his freaking signal to you, like, bitch, chill the fuck out. Maybe he doesn't really want to divorce you, but this is his only option because you don't know how to act. And you yourself just said you don't know how to act, but you didn't say it in those words, but you basically said it in those words. Now, how I coped with divorce was I was a happy motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I posted that shit on Instagram, made me a video about it. I was happy. And I cried because I was happy. So I really can't tell you how to cope with it because this is something that I wanted and I was ready. But a lot of people cope with things a lot of different ways. I'm not saying get drunk and start drinking, bitch. But what I am saying is, why don't you put peace between you and him? That's maybe the first thing that you need to do, because you guys are kind of getting divorced on a sour note. You know what I'm saying? Because he's tired of your shit. And maybe you need to put peace. Angry. You guys can go through this peacefully and help one another. Sometimes people get divorced and they're still the best of friends, and you just be like, why'd y'all even get divorced from one another? But it works out like that. That's just how it is. So to me, I think that's how you should end up coping with it, is putting peace between you and him and apologizing to him first for being an asshole for all those years. Now, you never said that he was an asshole to you. You just said, I was constantly yelling at him for no reason. So this is what you need to come to terms and be a woman and let him know how you felt, how you disrespected him, and let him express himself to you as to how it made him feel as a person. Because even though he's a man, he has feelings too, regardless of what. He has feelings too. And just like you explained in your email, even though it was a short email, I read right through it. You just said because of your cheating ways and the things that you've done to him, you could never respect him because he forgave you. What kind of bullshit is that? You couldn't respect him because he forgave you? Like, that's some crazy wild shit. Like, I'm sorry, but I'm not about to. If I cheated on my ex-husband and he forgave me, I would just be so happy that he forgave me, because I would never want to be cheated on. But I still wouldn't treat him like shit. But that's what you did. And that probably hurt him so much that he just really basically didn't know how to deal with it. And as human beings, as people, sometimes we can only take but so much. And then it comes a point in our lives where it's like, you know what? I'm going to back the fuck off. And I'm going to leave her alone. Even though I don't want to be without this person, I'm going to back the fuck off and I'm going to leave them alone. And that's probably where he's came to terms with. But maybe you should have a conversation with this man and see how you have made him feel. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm pretty sure you have broken him down and broken his spirit down. And that's how you're going to have to deal with it. You can't always think about yourself, because obviously you've been thinking about yourself for all these years by cussing this man out, yelling at him, cheating on him, and he ain't been nothing but good to you. And he got tired of it. And now you're coming to me talking about how you cope with it. Why don't you figure out how he's going to deal with this? How this has all affected him and has hurt him. And maybe that'll be able to help you cope with your own divorce. And maybe that'll bring peace between the two of you. And also for your children. You know what I'm saying? Just like I said, we go through some shit as women. And a lot of it reflects from our relationships. And then our kids got to see this. And it's not fair to them. You know what I'm saying? It's just not fair to them. It is what it is. So this is going to be the last one. Hey, Miss April, I need your help. I'm 23. I met this guy online. He's 2 years older than me. We exchanged numbers so we can get to know each other better. We hit it off. We talk every single day and text a lot. I thought I found the one. Fast forward 3 months passed and we were ready to meet each other. By the way, I live in Texas and he lives in Boston. I decided that I would go visit him. I saved up, got my ticket, and I was so excited. Well, I get to Boston so nervous. I get to baggage claim, and we spot each other. The first words that came out of his mouth were, "You don't look like your pictures." Us girls do the angels with the camera to look cute. But I didn't think I looked that much different. Oh, us girls do the angles. Us girls do the angles. You know, like angles with the camera to look cute. But I didn't think I looked that much different. I was a little disappointed because of his face when he said that. I brushed it off. When we went to his apartment, he didn't say much. So we watched a movie and I lost my virginity that night. I was ready. I loved him. The trip was okay. He nitpicked at everything. Told me I had a nice body. He told me I had a nice body shape, but I needed to lose the gut. Told me he didn't like the way I dressed and told me what I should be wearing. I went back home, and as soon as the plane touched down, I called to let him know I made it. He told me he was busy and he called me back. I didn't hear from him in 2 weeks. He told me he went to the beach and his phone fell in the ocean. But he also has a house phone and I called that as well. Well, fast forward again. I've been the one going back to Boston to visit. I met his dad who doesn't like me. I overheard him tell my boyfriend that I was fat and he could do better. Wow. He said that he was getting tired of long distance and wanted me to move there with him. I saved up, packed up, and went to Boston. I was there for 2 days and was pawning off to his cousins because he didn't want to hang out with... Oh, wow. I was there for 2 days and he was pawning me off to his cousins because he didn't want to hang out with me. He would yell at me and tell me to go do something. I was already tired and ready to go back home. And it had only been a week. Now I've been there 4 months. He proposed, but I don't really want to marry him. We have a lot of issues. He gave me a used ring. It has scratches on it and he didn't even have a box. He couldn't tell me where he got it from. I'm going to go back to Texas for a week to visit my family. And I'm thinking of just staying with my mom in Texas until I get back on my feet. Because I don't want to be with him anymore. My friend said I should work it out. But he still tells me how fat I am. He picks out my clothes when we shop. He one time went to the movies with his cousin and his two girls. I found out he went to the movies with his cousin and these two girls. I found out and yelled at him for it. He said that it wasn't a date, that his cousin was on the date and he needed someone to keep the friend company. When I called, he doesn't answer, so I call block and then she calls private and then he'll pick up. He says he loves me, but it's love support. Supposed to hurt. Help me. Wow. So did she give me a name? No, she didn't. Okay, Angel, because that's what I said, Angel. Angel is 23. The guy is 2 years older. She met him online. She lives in Texas. He lives in Boston. You know, she went there after like 3-4 months to finally get to meet him. She flew all the way from Texas to Boston. And when she got to baggage claim, this motherfucker was like, "Oh, you don't look like your pictures." Like, wow, are you serious? But on top of that, you talking about you need to lose the weight. He don't like how you dress. Then he's tired of the long-distance relationship. So she overheard his father, her boyfriend's father, talking about he could do better because she's fat, overweight. And he treats her like shit. Then he gives her a used ring. And she moves out there. She packs all her shit up, saves some money, packs all her shit up, and moves to freaking Boston. But you move all the way out there, and he treats you like shit, don't want to hang out with you. First of all, here's my thing. Why the fuck would you want to go back? So basically, Angel then went back home to Texas to just chill with her mom, and she does not want to come back. I'm sorry, but I wouldn't come back neither. Your friends are telling you to work it out. Let me tell you something. There's a fine line between love and hate, and he's just disrespectful and ignorant. If he could tell you that you're fat or you need to lose your stomach, he don't like how you dress, he don't want to hang out with you, you hear his father talking about how he don't like you and all that extra shit, bitch, why is you wanting to go back there? Okay, you didn't even enjoy your time the first time you went because the nigga fucking drops you off at the airport, you get home to let him know that you made it back to Texas, and you don't hear from him for 2 weeks talking about he went to the beach and his phone fell in the ocean. That is the lamest bullshit story I've ever heard. It does not take people 2 weeks to get a new phone. However, for some people, it just might. But here's the kicker. If you got a house phone, motherfucker, then why ain't you calling me anyway? He is a worthless piece of shit. And I'm sorry, but I would not have moved all the way across country for some motherfucker that I met online. You just moved from Texas to Boston. I live in New York and I live in Arizona now. That's the same distance, you know what I'm saying? Because Boston is right there next to New York. So you kind of like, but I didn't move here for no man. I moved here because I wanted to get the fuck away. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know anything about Arizona. I moved here because of those purposes only. And because my web developer lived out here and I knew it was beautiful and she was here for me. The only family that I really had. So if I needed anything, I knew that I could count on her. But you moved for some dick that really ain't even good dick because he don't give a fuck about you. And now you got some friends that are supposed to be your friends talking about you could work it out. What is there to work the fuck out? He treats you like shit. There's nothing to work out. What you need to do is take your black ass back home and stay there with your mother. Regardless if you're black or white, who knows what color you are, but I'm going to just say that. You need to stay at home because you're miserable. Why would you want to marry somebody like that? Why would you want to move cross country for somebody like that? If he did not call you for 2 weeks, why would you move to another state? Okay? That right there shows stupidity on your part. And yes, we all do things for love. It's okay. It is true. Okay? And I might be a little bit harsh by saying that stupidity on your part. But here's the thing. You are right. Love is not supposed to hurt. And what I would do is I would tell that motherfucker to kiss my ass. Okay? Kiss it. Put that bitch in a ditch. Leave that bitch in a ditch is what the fuck I would do. Like I said on my last video. Leave that bitch in a ditch. He's not worth your sanity. And those are your friends? Girlfriend, you need to find some new fucking friends. Because if your friends is telling you to work it out, and if you explain to them the same shit that you've explained to me in this email, and they're telling you to work it out, then them bitches really don't want much in life but to be loved by whoever or just to have a relationship. If your friends are telling you to work it out, and they know all the shit that's going through, you're going through right now, your friends need to be not your friends anymore. That is why I say my circle is like a dot because a bitch is like this. If that was my girl Shay and I told her some shit like that, she would go the fuck off on me and tell me what it really is like as a friend, okay? Because she has done that on numerous occasions about certain shit. So that's what a real friend is. A real friend is going to tell you some shit that you really don't want to hear, but it's for your own good. And that's what a friend is. But you got some bitches that are misleading you into a relationship so them fucking bitches could come out to Boston and live it up or probably just visit. You need to keep your ass back in Texas and go home, mama. Take your ass and go home. You young, take your ass and go home and stay the fuck off of any website dating line. Online dating site. And if you do want to date someone, try to find a local motherfucker, not somebody that's all across the country. He talk about he didn't know you look like that. Nigga, I didn't know your attitude and you as a person were like that. Okay, so if he's talking about you got flaws, then this motherfucker got a whole lot of other flaws that you just don't have. Fuck how you look. It's personality and who you are as a person is what really counts. Fucking looks don't count. And if his daddy don't like you talking about he could do better, bitch, let him find somebody that he think can do better. But I tell you what, Angel, you can do better. You can do better. So don't call him. I hope you took all your shit from Boston and went back to Texas with it. And if you did leave some things there like clothes, you know what? They're replaceable. It's not worth your time and your sanity. cut that nigga off, leave that bitch in the ditch, and get to stepping. There's no way that I would let my friends coast me into making shit work. Boy, bye. You know what I'm saying? Boy, bye. And that's just my final note. So on that note, let Angel know what you would do in that situation, moving across country for some fucking lowlife that you even barely know. That was just like really foolish, okay? On some real shit. Really fucking foolish. But it is called real talk. But yes, you guys. So on that note, I'm about to go to making dinner for my kids. It is 7:36, so God knows when dinner's going to be ready. But I have to go to the store and get some cooking oil. Maybe I'll just buy them some takeout food tonight because I got some coupons anyway. Yes. But on that note, stay diva and divalicious. Leave your comments below. Make sure you check out my new makeup line, Extreme Lips. Extreme. And yes, I will post the pictures up so you guys can see in the website below. See you guys soon.